is out to destroy you and to cause you to lose your soul.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't know enough.
Yes. Come on.
The devil will have you believing that the Bible is a preacher's book. So you don't read the Bible. You let the preacher read the Bible and let him tell you what the Bible says. No, ma'am and no, sir.
Right.
You have to know the word of God for yourself. That's why Paul told Timothy, man, study the word.
Yes,
sir.
You study. We all in here ought to be students of the Bible. It's not just a preacher's book. It's every traveler's roadmap. If you're trying to get to heaven, the Bible tells you how to do it.
The roadmap.
Lord, this book. Come on.
Didn't Jesus say, I am the way, the truth, and the life? No man cometh to the Father but by me. Jesus is the way. Well, how do you learn about Jesus? You open the book.
You gotta open the book and take a look.
That's right.
Amen. The devil is cunning.
Yes, he is.
He knows what tricks to play on people.
Oh, yeah.
He don't play the same tricks on everybody. He knows what tricks to play on you and I. If you don't believe it, we're going to stand in just a little while and we're going to extend the invitation. And when we extend the invitation, that's your invitation to come forward. Many people who are lost, they begin to start scratching their head. Begin to start wondering. And then what happens? Their feet get heavy.
Yeah.
Huh? And then after a while, what happens is that the devil says, well, just wait. And what you have to understand is that your soul is on the line. Don't the devil says, don't just rush into anything. You have plenty of time. We don't know how much time we have. Look out for the tricks of the devil. The devil will tell you, what are your mama and your daddy going to say about it? You don't worry about that. Because your mother and your father or your friends cannot save you.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. You got to save yourself.
Paul, when he became a child of God in Galatians chapter 1, Paul said that when I accepted the word of God, I conferred not with flesh and blood. We have to understand how important it is that we have to choose God for ourselves. Because we're going to be judged. Not based upon what my friends say. Not based upon what my family says. Not based upon what I believe. But based upon the teaching of the Word of God.
That's right.
The devil plays tricks. Another trick that he has is that he likes to use other folk. To keep you out of the church.
Oh yeah.
What am my family going to say? I told you that. Jesus said on one occasion that your foes, your worst foes, will be that of your own house. Because you hear you are trying to do what's right, and they will look at you. I remember some time ago, our minister, he's passed on now, but he was from South Carolina. He would talk about how that he would go down to South Carolina and try to teach his family about God. He said he couldn't stay down there no more than 3 days because they made it so hard for him.
Yeah.
Family would do that.
Yeah.
But you have to have enough energy and enough faith on the inside to do what God says.
Amen.
The devil knows that there is just but one church.
Amen.
Huh?
He didn't make but one.
Now see, you may not know it.
yeah.
But the devil knows that.
He knows.
Uh-huh. Yes. The devil knows that there is just but one true church.
One Lord, one faith.
One baptism. And you say, well, I thought that all of these churches belong to Christ. But see, that's what you get for thought.
For thought.
Naaman thought that the rivers out there was better than the river Jordan. But they didn't have healing. Amen. And he plays tricks. Listen here. The devil knows. The devil knows that the Bible says in Matthew 16:18 that Jesus promised to build his church upon this rock. I will build my church. He knows that. And let me tell you something. That's why he created many churches.
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Somebody said, well, where did all these churches come from? Well, where did they come from? They came from man.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's either Christ or man. Yeah. Christ says, I have but one.
Yeah. Yeah.
We talked about that last night. He says, I only have one. Well, if he only has these churches out here today are nothing more than the result of man-made doctrine.
That's right.
Amen. Did you hear what I said?
Right.
And so what happens is that many people began to think, well, you know, all of these churches can't be wrong. A lot of people say, well, you know, get from me Matthew chapter 7.
That's it.
Ooh. A lot of people say, well, you know, all these churches can't be wrong because you see, what that means is that all these people, all these folk out here are going to be lost. Well, listen here. What do you think about all of those people in Genesis chapter 6 that was lost in the flood?
Right.
Huh?
Yeah.
All those folk was lost.
That's right.
8 souls saved by water. But in Matthew chapter 7, and let's begin reading at about verse number 13. What does the Bible say there?
Enter ye in at the straight gate.
Listen to what it says. Enter ye in at the straight gate.
Yeah.
For wide is the gate.
Wide is the gate.
And broad is the way.
Broad is the way.
That leads to destruction.
That leads to destruction.
And many be that go.
I'm telling you today that the broad way may be the popular way, but the broad way leads to death.
That's right.
That's why he says, enter ye in at the straight gate.
Sure.
You got many people in the world today who are going down the broad way.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know the mayor goes there.
Yeah.
The police chief go over there.
Yep.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
You know the president of the college, he goes there.
Right.
So if the president goes over there and if the chief goes over there, then it can't be wrong.
It can be.
And then there are people who look at the building, oh, that's such a beautiful building. And fail to understand that the church is not a building.
Amen.
Mm. Satan has done a job. And see, Satan will keep you blind. Let's read a little bit further.
Because straight is the gate.
Is the gate.
And narrow is the way.
It's the way.
Yeah.
Which leads to life.
And few.
There be that find it.
Come on.
I can tell you right now that the majority of the world is going to be lost.
That's right. Amen.
Just like it lost in Noah's day.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Because people won't take time to look for the straight gate. They'll be caught up in what everybody else is doing. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
And that's that's exactly what Satan wants. Look at other people. Never mind what the Bible says, but look at those other folk. Man, Satan's deceptive. He's deceptive. And he says that the small gate, because people will miss it because they're looking at other folks instead of looking at what the Word of God says. Amen. I will build my church, and so what we have to understand is that Satan, he works many times on our ignorance. You see, he works on our ignorance. The Bible says in John chapter 6, in verse number 45, it is written in the prophets, and they shall all be taught of God. Every man, therefore, that hath heard and hath learned of the Father does what? They come unto me. There is a hearing and a learning that results in a person coming to Christ Jesus. And if they have heard the right thing, and if they learn the right thing, and don't come to Jesus, it's only because they have been tricked by Satan. Satan realizes that knowledge is the key to salvation. And that's why we have to understand the importance of when we teach and when we preach to people to keep it simple. Is that all right? Keep it simple, so that people can understand. When we preach, people should not have to have a Bible and a dictionary to figure out what